Georgie Horniman was a Britisher by birth, but he was a staunch supporter of India, especially during her struggle for independence. He had come down from England to be the editor of the Bombay Chronicle, an English daily started by Sir Feroz Shah Mehta. Seeing the atrocities committed by the British government on Indians in India, he used his post to lash out against his own government. Indians had no freedom in their own land, not even freedom of speech. He freely criticized his countrymen for their wrong policies. He became a champion of India's independence movement. The British government tolerated this for some time. Several warnings were issued to him, but he paid no heed to them. He continued to use the paper to criticize the undemocratic, corrupt, and harsh regime of the Britishers. When they could not tolerate it anymore, the British Viceroy, Lord Wavell, issued orders for his deportation. And that is how B.G. Horniman found himself back in London on a cold, chilly afternoon. But he was not one to take these orders lying down. He was very angry and upset. He kept thinking of ways to return to India. He knew his place was there, not in his hometown, London. One day, as he was taking a walk in a park, he removed the deportation order paper from his overcoat pocket and read it for the umpteenth time. "And you should never again land in India until His Majesty's government pleases to permit you." Suddenly, his face lit up. He was all smiles. An idea germinated in his mind. He rushed to meet his friend, who was a travel agent, and booked himself a ticket for Colombo. The next trip was sailing in a couple of weeks. Horniman paid the money and ensured himself a berth in the ship. His mind was working overtime. He could not stay away from India, especially now when she needed his services the most. It was as if India had cast a spell over him. He told nobody of his plans. Whenever his friends questioned him, he would say, "I'm going to Colombo for a long vacation." He was good at concealing his anxiety and his excitement. Finally, the day arrived. He packed a few belongings in a small bag and reached the port. When the officer checked his passport, he stopped him. "Sir, why are you going to Colombo?"
"For business," replied Horniman stiffly.
"Sir, mark my words, stay away from India. You will be arrested if you go there. Anyway, as part of my duty, I'm informing the officials in India that you are headed for Colombo."
"That's okay," smiled Horniman, happy to be boarding the ship. He spent a few relaxed days on board, reading, sleeping, and writing. Then the ship docked and he entered Colombo. He was getting restless now. The next night, he took a boat train to India and thereafter a mail train, which finally brought him to Victoria Terminus Bombay. The year was 1925. A big team of policemen was waiting for him at the platform. He was detained. Horniman was prepared for this. He was unperturbed. When he was brought before the state magistrate, orders for his rearrest were issued. The media got wind of this. They reported the matter and everybody began speculating about the fate of B.G. Horniman. They were wondering why he had done something as foolish as this. Finally, the day of judgment arrived. Horniman greeted the magistrate with respect. The magistrate returned a half smile. Then he asked Horniman, "Sir, you were deported to England and debarred forever from coming back to India. Then why did you return?" Horniman requested the magistrate to read the deportation order again. The magistrate complied. Then Horniman said, "Sir, on the basis of the deportation order served to me, I have committed no offence by coming to Bombay." The magistrate was confused. "What are you saying, sir?" Horniman replied, "Sir, the deportation order states that I can never land in India without the government's consent. I have not landed in India. I have alighted in India. You never land by train. You only alight from it. Therefore, I have not committed any offence. It is the police who have committed an offence by detaining and arresting me." Horniman flashed a big smile at the magistrate. The magistrate was at a total loss of words. Horniman's argument held a lot of weight. The case was dismissed. Horniman had made a case for himself to stay back in India. The media reported this. Horniman became a hero and continued to support India till he breathed his last in 1948.